Hello everyone, my name is Emmy and I'm with PumpAlarm.com. Today I am going to do an overview of what a sewage ejector pump is. A sewage ejector pump is a type of pump that moves wastewater and sewage from a building's lower level to a higher level like a main sewage line. Sewage ejector pumps are commonly used in basements and lower levels of buildings to pump the sewage away from your building. A sewage ejector float is a float used in conjunction with your sewage ejector pump. It is usually strapped onto the pump by a tether or a pole, and this float is made out of buoyant material so it can withstand the wastewater in the sewage ejector pump. As wastewater enters the pit, the float rises with the water level. When the float reaches a certain height, the float will trigger an alarm letting you know that you need to address the problem. It begins to pump the wastewater out and into a main sewer line close to your property. Once the water level in the pit drops to a certain height, your pump will turn off and your float will return to its normal operating level. The sewage ejector float is an essential component to the sewage ejector system. Without this float, the pump would continue to run, which would lead to burnout. If you're enjoying this content, please hit the like button below, subscribe to our channel, and hit that bell notification so you don't miss a single video. So I'm going to strap the pump alarm unit on to the discharge pipe. This rugged sewer ejector float switch will go into input 4 here. It is the only input that has the 3 prongs there. So we're gonna plug it in. We are going to come down into the pit here, and you want the float switch to go on the opposite side of your inlet pipe and away from this float. We don't want them hitting, causing false alarms or anything like that. So we are going to mount it on the other side of the inlet pipe. And the key to this is to leave enough room for the float switch to travel so it can tilt and give you an alarm. If you have it too tight or too close to the basin, it can hit it and it will not be able to tilt up to give you that alarm. So I'm gonna grab another zip tie here and leave enough room. Make sure it's on the opposite side of the inlet pipe here. We're going to strap it about here onto the pipe. Make sure it's on the other side of the float switch attached to the sewage ejector pump. And this gives us enough room to where the float can come fully in motion here. And we are good to go. Follow us on Twitter, Facebook, and LinkedIn. For more information, head over to our website at PumpAlarm.com.